just let it do its thing. Now, what if we don't allow the volume to expand? What if we put the dry ice in there, we release all this gas really fast, but we do not let the volume expand?
And listen, I sit back with my brand new invention. Something grabs a hold of me tightly, flow like a harpoon daily and nightly. Some wind action.
Expanding. You can hear it cracking. You must stand back.
Okay. Some wind action.
But it takes a little bit. We're pumping all that gas in it. These containers are designed to hold a certain amount of pressure. But we can see that it's really starting to deform now. Look what you did. Look at all the pressure that built up inside the container. Now, this is just a thin bit of plastic. Now, you can understand why we're not doing the very large one. Tiny little pressure waves. This was a large pressure wave. That's why the bang was really loud. But typically speaking, when we're talking about pressure, pressure is sound. Sound is pressure. And so we created a loud noise by creating a very large release of pressure all at once. Thunder, same thing. When lightning strikes, it heats up the air around it, creates a very large wave of very hot particles that expands quickly. It's a pressure wave. That's why thunder is so loud. Okay, same idea here. So this dry ice basically blew the bottle apart because the pressure built up, and when pressure builds up, volume needs to expand, and the bottle was containing it, and so it got to a point where no longer could it hold in all the pressure, and it exploded. And it exploded in one really nice, violent demonstration. Jack, police on the scene, you know what I mean? They passed me up, could run it all, I don't mean. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it.
What are you doing? Oh.
Take heed, because I'm a lyrical poet. Miami's on the scene, just in case you didn't know it. My town that created all the bass sounds.